Good morning. Hey, hola, namaste, ciao, aloha, kumusta, bonjour, bonjour, yeah. Hi, konnichiwa, there you go, yes, hi, talofa, there you go, maya paabak. Good morning, everyone. I believe that this Sunday, today, is a wonderful day, right? Yeah. Amen. And can we wave and say hi to all those families, friends joining us online? Thank you so much for joining us in our worship today and every Sunday. May God bless you all. So, church, 2 weeks from now, there will be a great event at Journey United Methodist Church. And what will be? It will be our 10th anniversary. So, please, I know that you are praying for that, and we are praying for that. We have a lot of things going on, preparation, the cleanup yesterday. And have you noticed the railings in front? Thank you so much. Yeah, the trustee. Thank you so much, the donors, and may God bless you. And to those who came yesterday for the cleanup, thank you. Thank you so much. Can we give them a big round of applause? I won't mention name. I might forget someone. So everyone, thank you so much. And still, we need more cleanup for the preparation for the 10th year anniversary. And just drop by and by your whatever your schedule will be. We need help from each and every one of us. So, church, we will be talking today about, are we alarmed of what is going on? No. Why? Because Jesus is always with us. Amen. So, church, I know God is always there with us. God is always with us, I may say, 24/7. Let me try it. God is good 24/7. Take two. God is good 24/7. To God be the glory. Children, are you ready? Coming up. Children, excited, huh? All children. Yay. And Barbara will lead us in our children's moment. Children. Oh, I saw a little children there. Children coming up. Savannah, there you go. Hi.
Just a teeny bit so I can fit in there because I'm not skinny.
Hi, Rex.
Hi, how are you?
Good.
All right. Excuse me.
Rex.
Oh, thank you.
Baby, the sun on
Oh, dear. Maybe I'm allergic to... sitting up here in front, what do you think?
The shirt button five.
All right, I have sort of a interesting topic today. Do you think God causes bad things to happen?
No.
No.
No, absolutely.
Do you think he's always with us when bad things happen?
Okay. Yes.
Yes.
Absolutely.
Okay,
yes.
Absolutely.
Boo.
Boo. All right, so I think you're right about that.
The baby stayed with Frank.
And do you think he can stop all bad things from happening?
No.
No. No, I don't think
bad,
so.
Bad, bad, bad.
Like people are going to get in by a shock.
You know, the hardest question I ever had to answer as a mom was when my daughter was about, I don't know, 7 or 8, and she had a friend who was very sick, and she said to me, why does God let bad things happen to good people? And I had a struggle to answer that question, but I finally said, I don't think he causes the bad things to happen, but I think he's always with us. And if we pray and we believe, then sometimes the good things will turn out okay, and sometimes it just helps us to get through the bad things. So that's what our verse is about today, our story is about today, is that whether or not God is always with us. And we have to believe that, don't we? Now, how do we show God that we believe that? Well, by maybe doing good things, by maybe going to church, by maybe praying,
learning about him.
And learning about him, maybe if you're old enough to read the Bible.
Nope,
maybe you're not old enough yet. Not quite yet.
She's only four.
I know. And by going to church and worshiping with our community of faith, right?
Mm-hmm.
Right. Okay, let's do a little prayer. Are you guys singing a song today?
Yeah. We do not know what song.
You don't know what song. Okay, well, it'll be a surprise for all of us. Dear God, okay, now we're going to pray. You have to be really quiet now. Shh. Dear God, please help us to always remember that you are always with us in the good times and in the bad times, in the sad times and the happy times. Help us to never, never forget that. It's so important for us to always remember that and not just wallow around in our sad moments. So help us always to be strong. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen.
Amen.
All right, so you're going to sing a song. Do we know what song they're singing? Pastor, are we? Oh, they are not singing today. All right, so that's a surprise. We're not singing today. All right. Let's quietly walk to class. All right.
Excuse me a moment. You would like to stand up and say something to the class.
Okay.
And as you are comfortable, please stand. Let our hearts rejoice in the God of hope and faithfulness. Our foundation is the cornerstone that never fails. Hope arises as the tools of war are broken and the weak are given strength. God comes bringing judgment to the ends of the earth, calling us to hope and faithfulness. Amen.
Oh,
pray together. God of possibilities, fill us with your hope and faithfulness. Listen to us as we pour our war before you. Grant us the grace to be your people and to live your teachings. Live in us that we may arise with hope and walk in love. In the name of Christ, our rock, we pray.
You may be seated. First reading for today is Samuel chapter 1, verse 4 to 20. Whenever Elkanah offered a sacrifice, he gave some of the meat to Peninnah and some to each of her sons and daughters. But he gave Hannah even more because he loved Hannah very much, even though the Lord had kept her from having children of her own. Peninnah liked to make Hannah feel miserable about not having any children, especially when the family went to the house of the Lord each year. One day, Elkanah was there offering a sacrifice when Hannah began crying and refused to eat. So Elkanah asked, "Hannah, why are you crying? Why won't you eat? Why do you feel so bad? Don't I mean more to you than 10 sons?" When the sacrifice had been offered and they had eaten the meal, Hannah got up and went to pray. Eli was sitting in his chair near the door to the place of worship. Hannah was heartbroken and was crying as she prayed. "Lord all-powerful, I am your servant, but I am so miserable. Please let me have a son. I promise to give him to you for as long as he lives, and his hair will never be cut." Hannah prayed silently to the Lord for a long time, but her lips were moving, and Eli thought she was drunk. "How long are you going to stay drunk?" he asked. "Sober up." "Sir, please don't think I'm no good," Hannah answered. "I'm not drunk, and I haven't been drinking, but I do feel miserable and terribly upset. I've been praying all this time, telling the Lord about my problems." Eli replied, "Go home. Everything will be fine. The God of Israel will answer your prayer." "Sir, thank you for being so kind to me," Hannah said. Then she left, and after eating something, she felt much better. Samuel is born. Elkanah and his family got up early the next morning and worshiped the Lord. Then they went back home to Ramah. Later, the Lord blessed Elkanah and Hannah with a son. She named him Samuel because she had asked the Lord for him. Please stand for the reading of the gospel. As Jesus was leaving the temple, one of his disciples said to him, "Teacher, look at these beautiful stones and the wonderful buildings." Jesus replied, "Do you see these huge buildings? They will certainly be torn down. Not one stone will be left in place." Later, as Jesus was sitting on the Mount of Olives across the temple, Peter, James, John, and Andrew came to him in private. They asked, "When will these happen? What will be the sign as they are about to take place?" Jesus answered, "Watch out and don't let anyone fool you. Many will come and claim to be me. They will use my name and fool many people. When you hear about wars and threats of wars, don't be afraid. These things will have to happen first, but that isn't the end. Nations and kingdoms will go to war against each other. There will be earthquakes in many places, and people will starve to death. But this is just the beginning of troubles." The word of God for the people of God.
Thanks be to God.
The gospel of our Lord.
Again to me, wonderful words of life. Let me more of their beauty see. Wonderful words of life, words of life and beauty, teach me faith and duty. Beautiful words, wonderful words, wonderful words of life. Beautiful words, wonderful words, wonderful words of life. Amen. You may be seated. It's been quite a while that I haven't sung, right? I will sing again today. Great is thy faithfulness. I know you know this song. Amen? Amen? November is Thanksgiving and Harvest Month. So next Sunday, we will be having or celebrate our Thanksgiving Sunday. So we have a lot of blessing to give thanks to the Lord. And one of that is we are alive. Amen? We are alive. We wake up this morning. God blessed us. God is always God 24/7. So if you know this song, join me. I know you know this song. Great is thy faithfulness. Great is thy faithfulness, O God, my Father. There is no shadow of turning with thee. Thou changest not thy compassions, they fail not. As thou hast been, thou forever. Great is thy faithfulness, great is thy faithfulness. Morning by morning, new mercies I see. All I have needed, thy hand hath provided. Great is thy faithfulness, Lord, unto me. Summer and winter and springtime and harvest, sun, moon, and stars in their courses above, join with all nature in manifold witness to thy great faithfulness, mercy and love. Great is thy faithfulness, great is thy faithfulness. Morning by morning, new mercy I see. All I have needed, thy hand hath provided. Great is thy faithfulness, Lord, unto me. Pardon for sin and a peace that endureth. Thine own dear presence to cheer and to guide. Strength for today and bright hope for tomorrow. Blessings all mine with 10,000 beside. Great is thy faithfulness, great is thy faithfulness. Morning by morning, mercies I see. All I have needed, thy hand hath provided. Great is thy faithfulness, Lord, unto thee. again, refrain. Great is thy faithfulness. Great is thy faithfulness. Morning by morning, new mercies I see. All I have needed, thy hand hath provided. Great is thy faithfulness, Lord, unto thee. Amen. Join me in the attitude of prayer. Great is your faithfulness, O God. Yes, truly. We felt it every day. Be with us as we listen to your word. And remind us again, O God, not to be alarmed, because you are in control. Open our hearts to your truth today. Help us see beyond our fears and our certainties to the hope of the assurance that you are with us. In your name we pray. Amen. Church, it is okay that sometimes, that to be okay, I keep on telling you this, and it is also okay that sometimes we feel alarmed of what is going on to ourselves, our families, and what is going on to the community. And it is really complicated, I may say, in today's generation. A lot of wars going on, a lot of fight, and sometimes even in the family. But I believe God is in control. Amen? It is not all about us. It is not all about me, you, or everyone. But it is all about God. God is doing new things, not for helping us or feeling us to have that bitter feeling, but to have a better living. In the scripture today, it is all about Jesus said to his disciples, "Do not be alarmed." Let me share 3 points in this worship service about not to be alarmed. Number one, trust God because God has an unshakable plan. Right? Let us trust God. Even sometimes we worry a lot. Even pastors worry. Even myself, it doesn't mean that I am a pastor, I don't worry. No. We worry. We have a lot on our plate. Right? Jesus said, as Jesus left the temple, one of his disciple teachers, "Look, what an awesome stone and building." Jesus replied, "Do you see those enormous buildings? Not even one stone will be left upon another. All will be demolished." Though the disciples marveled of the temple, but Jesus reminded them that even this seemingly indestructible structure would crumble. Jesus said, "Do not place ultimate trust in earthly institution. September 11, what was that? The two tallest building in the United States were destructed. And a lot of buildings, institutions are destructible. Remember the Old Testament time when they wanted to build a temple? They wanted to be like God. Those buildings, institutions are destructible. Do not place ultimate trust on earthly institution. There is a true story in the Philippines. After 50 years of working as a supervisor nurse here in the United States, she had a lot of, I may say, millions of pesos. So they bought a multi-million mansion. They bought farm, a lot, a big, huge farmland. But last week, there was a super typhoon in the Philippines. The mansion was destructed. The farmland, too, was underwater before they harvest anything. This is really a sad story. And a lot of people in Florida, the hurricane, a lot of devastations, right? And this is real, and this is happening, not only in the United States, not only in the Philippines, but around the world. Anything happens. Church, even the temple of Jerusalem was destroyed AD 70. Wow! A temple made by huge different kinds of materials, but it was destroyed. The temple represented more of the architecture before, during the Old Testament time. But church, the temple of the Lord is within our body. That temple will never be destroyed but by anyone. Why? Because it is God's temple. So whatever lies temple in your today, whatever struggles, I may say, distracted by different kinds of pains, situations, remember, we can find peace in knowing God. Maybe those temples or institutions like careers, relationship, financial security, and even health. Sometimes you are being rattled by our faith because of all these. But today, God is reminding us, let us trust God. Sometimes there is a time that we want to quit, right? I don't take it anymore. I cannot do it anymore. My career is in a bad shape. Our relationship is a broken relationship, ups and downs. We have financial struggles. But let us remain in God, because God will never be unshakable. Another thing is, let us be alert of what is going on. Not alarmed. Alert. There's a song, a fellowship song, I'm awake, alert, alive, enthusiastic. Remember that song? A Sunday school song. I'm awake, alert, alive, enthusiastic. I'm awake, alert, alive, enthusiastic. I'm awake, alert, alive. I'm awake, alert, alive. I'm awake, alert, alive, enthusiastic. It's a Sunday school song. Let us be alert, not alarmed. Even sometimes we feel that alarm. 2 weeks from now, we will celebrate 10-year anniversary. Maybe among people around here who is alarmed, it's me. Because I'm your pastor, you know. But when I feel that alarm, I bow my head. Lord, you are in control, okay? There you go. Let us be awake. Let us be alive and enthusiastic, not alarmed. Jesus was sitting on the Mount of Olives across from the temple. Peter, James, and John, and Andrew asked Jesus privately, tell us, Jesus, when these things happen, what sign will show that all things are about to come to an end? They were alarmed. Even the 12 disciples were alarmed. Even those people that called by God in the Old Testament, in the New Testament, even in our generation, were alarmed. Like the song that I sung, I'm awake, I'm alive, and I am enthusiastic. Keep watch. There you go. Jesus said, watch out that no one can deceive you. In a social media, think. There's a advertisement. Think before click, right? Yeah? So don't post anything. Read it again and again before it posting it. Because when you post in the social media, it will went all over around the world. And you cannot erase it. Click before or think before you click. There is a story of a man who watched the news every day. I don't watch the news every day now. It makes me alarmed. And was constantly terrified by the latest headlines. One day, he decided to prepare for the apocalypse by building an underground bunker. Stock catastrophic happened, and he laughed and said, why am I doing this? Why am I doing this? I should believe in God. I should trust God. Not those people, not all journalists, right? Not the news in the television. It makes me alarmed. Why should I do this? I should have faith in God. And lastly, in time of not being alarmed, church, let us focus on our faithful living. There you go. Let us focus on our faithful living. Nations and kingdoms will fight each other, like what is going on. And there will be earthquakes, famines in all sorts of places. These things are just the beginning of suffering associated with the end. In our Methodist faith, this is what I like in our Methodist faith. We are more hopeful people. That's why we have the slogan, open doors, open minds, open hearts. Yes, we should not be alarmed of what is going on. But we are a resurrected people, meaning we believe in God, died on that cross, but resurrected in 3 days, meaning God is with us. So let us focus, church, on what we can do now. Let us pray every day, read the Bible and every day, and you will grow. Another Sunday school song. Read your Bible, pray every day, and you grow. Sometimes we don't really read the Bible. Right? Wake up, read the Bible, pray every day if you want to grow. So, church, in conclusion, stay in God's Word. Do not be alarmed. Meditate on these scriptures. We have a lot in social media now. Meditation every day. Every day I send meditation to my friends. Scripture readings. Why? It reminds us that God is faithful to you, to everyone. Remember that. And then let us pray continuously. Prayer is power. If you are alarmed, church, pray. Prayer is power. Prayer connects us to God so that we can have peace, so that we can have love. And lastly, let us actively love one another. In what way? Let us serve and help those around us, not only inside the Journey United Methodist community, but to those around us, even though we don't know them. Just saying, hello, hi, how are you? God loves you. It's a one way of helping others. Helping doesn't mean that you can help by monetary reason. Helping others is that you can say and reflect to yourself that Christ's love is on you and sharing them to all. Are you alarmed? Please do not be alarmed. Jesus said, I will never leave you nor forsake you. Amen. Please stand and join me in reciting the Lord's Prayer. Together, our Father,
you are invited to place a donation in one of the offering plates as they are passed by our ushers, or you can give online as shown on the screen or scan the QR code. Hannah offered the life of her much-awaited son that she might honor and glorify God. Jesus offered his very life that we might know God's love fully and completely. As we offer our gifts to God, let us do so with the same generosity of spirit that has been shown to us in so many ways.
together we will pray. God of all hopefulness, strengthen us this day to live in hope and gratitude. Give us the courage to live as people of generosity. Multiply our gifts that the hungry might be fed and the poor might find abundance. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen.
In the Lord.
You can clap.
As we depart from this place, be with us. Thank you for being with us every day to our family, community of faith. May you bless us all, O God. Another week is ahead of us. Bless us, O God. In your name we pray. Amen. So, church, go in peace. And may the good Lord be with you.